Greetings from the state capitol in Olympia. I'm Luanne Van-Werven, your state representative from Whatcom County's beautiful 42nd District. I'm grateful and humbled that you sent me to Olympia to represent you for a third term. I feel honored and privileged to represent you. I will be serving on three committees this session. I'm excited to share that I am the new ranking Republican on the House College and Workforce Development Committee. Previously, this was called the Higher Ed Committee, but the Democrat majority changed the name to College and Workforce Development. Regardless of the name change, we work on policy related to higher education issues. The ranking position means that I am the lead Republican for our caucus. I will work closely with the chair on the committee agenda, and it puts me in a position to be a strong voice for students and colleges in Whatcom County. It allows me to continue my work on college affordability and accountability. Also, I know that a four-year college degree is not for everyone. I want our kids to succeed, whether they choose a traditional route or the trades. I'm determined to connect them with successful careers. In addition to that committee, I am also serving on the House Transportation Committee and the Innovation, Technology, and Economic Development Committee, or ITED for short. This is a new committee assignment for me. As a member of the Transportation Committee, I welcome the opportunity to be involved in shaping our district's transportation needs, traffic issues, fuel prices, car tab fees, and major infrastructure projects. That's the good news. The bad news is that this will be a very challenging session. In the Higher Ed Committee, public hearings have already been held that would establish free college for students whose family's income doesn't meet a certain threshold. Let me be clear. I want affordable tuition for all students. The cost of tuition and textbooks have soared over the last 20 years, and it's time to turn that around. We are also seeing our freedoms and Second Amendment rights being threatened. There's legislation to ban small businesses from having booth rentals, and a number of bills related to firearms being pushed despite the restrictive initiative that just passed in November. I'm also concerned with the spending plan coming out of the governor's office. Governor Inslee's budget will increase over 20% over the last two-year budget. How many of you are able to increase your family budgets by 20%? The governor is proposing almost $4 billion in new tax increases to pay for this huge increase in budget growth. The governor is asking for a capital gains tax, even though the IRS and every state in the union agree that this is an income tax. This could target many people's retirement savings. Our district has rejected it by a wide margin each time it's been on the ballot. The people have spoken, and the courts have spoken. It is unpopular, unstable, and likely unconstitutional, and certainly not needed. The governor is also proposing a major increase in the state's business and occupation tax. It would have a negative impact to our Main Street businesses. This is unconscionable to me. The governor proposes altering the state's real estate excise tax. This will raise the prices on many home sales. Let me be clear, these tax proposals are not necessary. Budget writers are entering the next biennium with $4.2 billion in additional tax revenue. I believe with the amount of tax dollars coming in from you, the hardworking taxpayers, the legislature should find a way to return some of it to you, such as a property tax break or a sales tax reduction. Despite major differences on the budget, I want to stress that most legislation is bipartisan. Both parties often work together for the benefit of our districts. I have an open door policy, so I hope you will contact me during the session if you have any questions, comments, or concerns about legislation before us. Thank you.